And after learning so much more throughout the last month and a half, now I understand why the mom makes videos the way she does. And you're gonna see some of her videos today, and you're gonna be like, oh, it's not great. But then when you find out why, it just kind of makes sense. And now I feel kind of bad.
After watching the family of Jake Paul from Shane Dawson today, we really gotta sit back and ask ourselves, is Shane Dawson being manipulated by the Paul family? What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel is all about mental health. Most of it is about helping you improve your mental health. And what I like to do is pull things from the YouTube community or pop culture to try to teach you how to improve your mental health. So if you're into that, make sure you subscribe, ring that notification bell, because I make a ton of videos and I've been reviewing pretty much every episode of the Shane Dawson, Jake Paul series, all right? So before I get started, I got a little rant against Felix PewDiePie. PewDiePie, I forgot his last name. But I got a little rant. I didn't want to make a whole separate video for this. But I watched Felix's video about Shane Dawson, and you know, and he was just bringing up all the stuff people have already brought up. I'm surprised how late Felix was to this. But anyways, regardless of that, like Felix touched on a bunch of the same points that everybody touched on and everything. And you know, Felix is this loud voice. And like, man, I love Felix, I love PewDiePie, I think he's a really good dude, but like, when it comes to mental health and addiction topics, like, I don't know, he's very ignorant, and like, some of this, you know, happened when the whole Demi Lovato thing happened, and yeah, like, it was just, I made a video about this, I'll link it up in the info card, but here's my gripe with PewDiePie today. Okay, you know what? I'll shut up. I'll just play you this clip.
Services. I did, I think, a year ago, and they asked me to talk about that, and I'm like, okay, fine. But I would never want to take money from it. I would never want to take money for a mental health app. It just doesn't feel right. And I'm probably the most morally skewed person ever. So for me to come up with that conclusion and not Shane, it's kind of weird.
Like, what? Like, I don't get it. Like, this is crazy to me. This is absolutely nuts to me. So I saw a comment earlier on my channel and it said something to the effect of, like, I don't think it's right to have a mental health channel and promote, you know, your Patreon or merch, or I'm like, wait, what? What, like, I don't know what world people live in. I might make a separate video about PewDiePie, like, trying to discredit BetterHelp, which is ridiculous. Like, they basically are the middle person for people and therapists. Like, that's all they are. There might be bad therapists on there, but there might be good therapists. Like, what? But, like, to say it's immoral to get sponsored by a mental health place, like, okay, first off, does call Shane immoral for that? Like, PewDiePie has like the largest audience, and have any of you guys seen the clothing line that he started with his wife? Like, it's like a little squiggle line, and they sell it for like $25. Like, what? What? And they're saying it's immoral for Shane to be sponsored by a mental health place. Like, I don't get that. Like, should mental health be free? Should physical, you know, physical health be free? Like, going to the doctor? Like, some would say yes, and maybe, I don't know, maybe that's what PewDiePie is talking about, because PewDiePie is from places where they have universal healthcare, and that stuff is free, so maybe that's where he's coming from, but to call it immoral is really, really ridiculous. Like, I don't get that at all. Like, doctors who peddle medications just so they can get a kickback on it, even though the medication might be addictive and kill people, that is immoral. But saying, like, someone's getting sponsored to promote a mental health website that, or app that helps people, and like, no, I guess you could say this is biased because I'm supported by BetterHelp, but like, no, like, I don't back anything that I don't believe in. Like, I've had people come to me and ask me to talk about their product and things like that, and I'm like, absolutely not. A lot of them have been like, supplements and things for addiction, and I'm like, absolutely not. But anyways, that's my gripe with Felix. Sorry, I had to get that rant out of the way. Let's get into the topic of Shane Dawson. Like, this is something that I've been worried about since the start of the series. If any of you watched my last video, I touched on it, but now I'm going to expand deeper into it. So my fear is that Shane is going to get manipulated, and it's interesting too. I'll talk about this first. I had a comment, so I did like a whole live stream and reaction, and somebody said like, oh man, that's messed up that you said Shane needs better friends. Sorry, like, sorry about that. And I think that that comment might've thought, like, maybe thought I was referencing like people like Andrew or Garrett or, you know, even Ryland or Morgan. No, those people are great. But like, I think the person that comes to mind is like Tana Mojo, right? Like what, like Shane needs to stop surrounding himself by people who are constantly getting into stuff. So something that we were talking about in the live stream, and by the way, my videos are for you, okay? Like, so the definition of insanity is doing the same thing, expecting different results, right? Shane keeps hanging out with the same type of person. Shane keeps reaching out to the same kind of people. Shane is doing this over and over, but he's expecting a different result. That's insane. So like, one thing that I really hope at the end of this series is that we're able to like have some kind of recap video. Maybe he like sits back and reflects on this stuff, because there was a lot of stuff in the ending of this part three that made me think that maybe Shane like going back and editing this stuff is like, oh my God, like was I getting manipulated? But yeah, like I kind of was taken aback. Like some people are upset that I'm like giving Shane like some real talk, not like he'll ever see this video. But the thing is, like I always say this, the best friends in your life are gonna tell you what you need to hear and not what you wanna hear, all right? Like yeah, it sucks, but like I have to keep people around. I have to keep people around, like my girlfriend, my best friend, other people, all of you. I need to keep people around who put me in check, who say, Chris, you are messing up, all right? So like, no, like I love Shane. Shane is an amazing human being, but because I care about him, it's like, yo, dude, you need to quit hanging out with certain people. You need to quit trying to find the best in every single person. So as we go on and we keep watching this video, you just see Shane just feeling bad for everybody, just for Jake, and then for Logan, and then for the mom. I think the only person he didn't feel bad for was like the dad at some point, and like that's good. Another comment said that Shane is an empath, and absolutely, absolutely, and this is great. Like I made a video about why depression is awesome, and people who have experienced depression, they're more likely to be empathetic. It's an amazing quality. The problem is that for those of you out there who are empaths, it goes way too far, all right? And then what happens is we start to get taken advantage of. So much of our mental health is about balance. Like, yeah, we need to feel bad for people, but we also need to set up boundaries. Like, that's the give and take of this thing. Like, I need to feel bad for you, but I also need to say, yo, you need to get your stuff together. You know what I mean? So one of the things is about being an empath, and what you know, when I'm worried about Shane getting manipulated, like let's talk about the audience, okay? So my fear is that Shane is going to have the pendulum just keep shifting over and over. Now he did make a tweet about this, but so in the beginning, a bunch of people were worried that Shane was gonna try to, you know, sympathize with Jake Paul. So the pendulum swung this way, right? And he's like, okay, well, I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna almost vilify Jake Paul, right? And then all of a sudden people are like, oh no, you're stigmatizing people with mental illness, you're being mean. Boom, it goes the other way. So then in this video, he does this huge disclaimer and bam, it's going this way again. And he's starting to realize that. And man, if this is you, it will drive you nuts. Like I used to be the biggest people pleaser on earth. I was always trying to please everybody and it was screwing up my mental health. So when I talk about these things about Shane, like it's because I care about him and I wanna make sure that these things don't happen. But I don't know Shane, I'm not friends with Shane, but you're watching my video. So if you're a people pleaser, you need to start to get that thing in check. People pleasing is a very good thing because it means that you wanna help, it means that you wanna be kind, it means that you wanna be accountable. It means so many things and I need to make a video about that. But you need to take this people pleasing and find the balance in it. So basically at the end of this video, at the end of it, he starts showing clips of him and Katie Morton talking again. And yes. Like they start talking about this.
You'll leave every conversation feeling like it was worse for them and you feel bad for them.
I kind of feel a little bad for them too.
I know. You know, or you'll view them in a positive light. You're like, man, that must have been so hard for them. They're such a nice person.
And that's absolutely correct. And like, although these people may not be sociopaths and things like that, like Shane needs to be careful because like Katie was saying, they will They will screw you over and try to make you feel bad about it. Like, what? What? You need to sit back. So when I'm talking about Shane needs better friends, like, I think his friends are great, but I think, you know, some of the people in his inner circle, they need to call him out on it. Like, I think Shane's friends are better than people like Jake Paul and Logan Paul, like the friend circles they have. But one of my concerns when watching this video was like, whenever you heard Andrew talking, Andrew is very agreeable. Like anything that Shane said, Andrew kind of parroted it. And like that's just like, okay, Andrew, like, you know, give him some maybe real talk, have your own opinion on these things and stuff. Because one of the issues with, you know, the Paul brothers or people like Tana or these other YouTubers who are screwing up, like ThuziTube was, they keep all these people around them who just tell them yes, 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 all the time. And that's what gets you into crap, right? So like, while Shane isn't running out and obviously, you know, doing insane things, like Shane realized, and he mentioned it in his last video with Katie Morton, that the more he's caring about these people, the more he's trying to help, the more he's extending himself, the worse his mental health is getting. And again, you gotta put your oxygen mask on first before you help anybody else. So I'm hoping that you gain something from this video. I'm hoping that Shane is learning and growing from this experience so he doesn't get manipulated and used by the Paul family to have them, you know, make him feel bad for all these other things. Like, people need to start taking accountability for the decisions they make, all right? And like, that's the end of it. Like, I think, you know, if Shane would reflect on the whole Tana situation, that's why he got a little pushback on it, because he was making excuses for Tana. Oh, she's just a kid, and oh, you know, she did what he talks about. Like, she made him feel bad because Michael took so much advantage of her and just lied and all these other things. Like, what I was mentioning in the last video, and I'll touch on this for just a second because I'm talking forever, but Shane gets hyper-focused in the moment, which blocks out everything else. And here's what I mean by that. You might have been in a relationship in your life. Maybe you had a boyfriend or a girlfriend or a husband or a wife or a friend, right? And they just kept screwing you over. They kept screwing you over, they kept screwing you over, and then you just started to make excuses for them, right? Like, oh, it wasn't that bad. Oh, they were just having a bad day. Oh, you know what I mean? So you forget all of this crazy stuff they did because you're just like, okay, well, they're being nice right now, so I'm just gonna forget everything else. I'm not telling you to hold grudges, but you need to take all of the person into account when you're deciding how you wanna pursue this relationship, whether it's a friendship or an intimate relationship and things like that. And I think that's one of the issues that Shane has, is that he hyper-focuses on what's happening in that moment and forgetting all of the other things that are happening. Like I mentioned in my last video, like when he was feeling bad for Jake because his mom was filming him, but Jake literally terrorizes everybody in the Team 10 house, like Shane forgot about that in that moment. So anyways, I've talked too long. I would love to know your thoughts. Like, do you think the Paul family is going to manipulate Shane? Whether it's Jake Paul or Logan Paul or Greg Paul, like, do you think that's going to happen? And also, the mom, Pam, I'm not sure, like, she's the one who's been reaching out with Shane, So, I don't know, leave your comments down below, all right? But that's all I got for you this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And again, if you are new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And a huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. I'm sorry, but not sorry. I need support. I need to get new equipment and things like that. I'm kidding. But if you wanna support the channel on Patreon, you can do it for a buck. Hit your tap right there. All right, thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time.